Hello and welcome. In this video, I will explain to you the advantages of source separation. What is source separation? The idea behind source separation is that different household wastes are collected separately. Some of you may already separate your household waste into glass, plastic, and organic waste. This makes it easier to recover and reuse, for instance, plastics or glass, and to make new products out of it. A similar approach can be applied to wastewater and the recovery of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, as well as carbon. The wastewater can be distinguished into grey water, or water from showers, kitchens and sinks, water from the toilet, so-called black water, that contains feces and urine. You can also collect your urine separately, then you get urine and so-called brown water, which is only feces. Finally, it is also possible to collect kitchen waste separately, which makes sense as it is, as wastewater, essentially biomass. If you look at the nutrients and the different contents of these different streams, we see that the major share of nutrients is actually contained in urine, here in yellow. Contrary to this, most of the carbon can be found in the remaining fraction, the wastewater, including the kitchen waste, grey water and feces. In addition, source separation also helps to separate out pathogens and bacteria, as urine is hygienically safe and does not contain any nasty bugs. So, if we are, for instance, able to collect urine separately, you can almost directly use it as a fertilizer in agriculture. To be safe that there are really no pathogens, you should store it for about 6 months, however. If you have urine separately, you can also make struvite, a crystalline slow-release fertilizer. But it gets even better. If you collect grey water separately from black water, you also reduce the dilution of your feces with water. If you then can also reduce the flushing volume of your toilet, you can, for instance, compost your feces. This is really great, and this compost is not only contains nutrients, but also carbon. Compost is in fact exactly what your soil needs to be replenished of the nutrients, but also to keep its soil structure. You can make such a compost toilet easily yourself, as you can see here. Another thing you can do with such concentrated black water is you can make use of a process called anaerobic digestion. This is a process in which biogas is produced that then can then be burned for cooking, heating, or for electricity generation. Furthermore, in this process, nitrogen is not transformed into gases, it stays in the sludge and is therefore available as a nutrient in agriculture. Furthermore, you can also add kitchen waste to this process, which does increase your yields of nutrients and biogas. Finally, you can separate the grey water. This is not highly contaminated and can be treated and reused easily. A simple treatment that you can make use of is, for instance, the so-called reed bed, as can be seen here. So, when will you start separating your resources at source?